Mark, I'll get you guys in first, but I want to, you know, you realize what you're here on CNN, and you've done interviews. You know people just read headlines.
Definitely.
They will take you out of context, and that will stick with you.
Definitely.
You understand that?
Definitely. I mean, that's the whole point of us getting a chance to talk, because I at least want to have as many people as we have bashing us, you too, because people take what you say out of context in the headlines also, or whatever. That's why we talk about it and we explain to people what we meant and what we're trying to get across.
Because there was a headline that says you defend. There was a headline that said I defended her as well. I didn't defend her. I said there is what?
I'm not defending
it. It's context.
Yes. It's like I'm not focused on her.
Okay.
I'm focused
Thank
on
you.
These students.
Thank you, Barrett. You can come here and be my co-anchor.
No, anytime.
All right. So what do you guys think? Mark, what do you think of this
interview? I think it was a great interview. I was glad to hear Trinidad explain himself because, as you said, headlines often distort what people say and what people mean. And I'm always fascinated by the amount of burden and pressure people put on rap artists to police their language. No one asks Tarantino to reimagine the scene in Pulp Fiction where he himself uses the word, the N-word, repeatedly and probably gratuitously, just like in Django. I think it's rappers have an extra burden put on them. And I also think it's fascinating.
He has gotten criticized for that part.
No. There are some people who are now saying that they're critical of him using it. They're not critical of the word being used in the movies per se, whereas with rappers, they're saying rappers just shouldn't use it. Rap music just shouldn't have the N-word in it, or TV shows like Empire just shouldn't have the N-word in it. And what I'm saying is that perhaps that's a conversation that black people can have internally. What I find fascinating is that oftentimes white people are trying to legislate the N-word for black people, saying none of you people should use it. It's like, well, nah, y'all, you know, that's not your call to make.
Mark, the question comes down to this. Do we want the N-word being used out in society, or do we want to stop the N-word, which has become so, as it is, racially divisive? And I'll be real candid with you. I mean, Trinidad, I think you know.
Did you just say the N-word has become racially divisive?
No, I'm saying right now is the proof of it. Look at all of this and everything that's gone on, and we all condemn it when it's said, but then you want to keep the word alive. And Trinidad, I'll be honest with you. I think you know that we should probably get rid of the N-word, but in reality, I think many rappers are afraid that they'll lose out on money and sales in street cred if they don't stop using the word.
Go ahead. Ben, no, sir.
Street cred.
First of all, how you guys doing, Mark and Ben? Welcome to the conversation.
Good to see you, bro.
New boy. Go ahead. Hey, I'm here.
Go ahead. So what do you think about what he said?
Ben, that's definitely had nothing to do with it. We're not going to
then
take
why
it.
Why would you keep using it, though? I mean, why not pledge that you're not going to use it?
At the end of the day, Ben, we use the word because that's how we came up. We came up using the word, like, people you came up using the word in the wrong way. We came up using the word as, how you doing, my nigga? And when somebody say, my nigga, that means that, bro, you're my friend. I will call you, Ben, my nigga. And when I call you that, you do not feel that I hate you.
But what if Ben said to you, Trinidad, what's up, my nigga? What would you think?
Ben, what I would tell you, if I honestly felt that you were my nigga, then you are my nigga, Ben. Be honest with you, Ben. You understand, Ben.
If I use the N-word, it could quite possibly, and honestly probably should, cost me my career. And I don't understand why, when we know how divisive this word is, why we would not have people like you, Trinidad, you're a community, your people look up to you, young people look up to you,
yes.
And you're rapping about the word and making money on it, and they think they should be rapping the word
Hold on for one second, Mark. You can get it after him. Let Trinidad respond.
Ben, you see, you keep giving, you're giving the word too much power. I am making money off of
I'm not using
music.
It. You are.
I am making money off of doing music and being creative, sir. I'm not making money just because I use the N-word. Nobody goes to buy an album because it's full of the N-word.
Trinidad.
No, sir.
You wouldn't be on this show tonight if it wasn't for using the N-word in your rap music. Right. Let's be honest.
Go ahead, Mark.
First of all, he wouldn't be on the show if a white woman hadn't said the N-word on a tape. So that's not fair.
Which was on his music.
Let me finish, Ben. The first white people were saying nigga before Trinidad James was born. And to sit here and say that the N-word has become divisive is absurd. The N-word is born out of slavery, it's born out of white supremacy.
I'm agreeing with you.
No, you're not. Listen, just
why would we keep the word alive?
Just listen for me. This is the problem. When we start talking about issues around race and racism, sometimes white people need to just listen. Just hear what I'm saying for a minute, Ben. saying. What I'm saying is that the N-word isn't divisive. White supremacy is divisive. Slavery was divisive. That's the problem. And maybe, just maybe, it's not white people's position to tell black people what to say. I might see Trinidad James on the street and call him my nigga. You know why? Because he is my nigga. And the difference between Trinidad James and you is that Trinidad James has to deal with the same oppressive situations. He's born to a world where anti-black racism prevails. He lives in a world where police might shoot him on the street no matter how much money he has. We share a collective condition known as nigga. White people don't. I'm not saying it should be illegal for white people to use it. I'm saying y'all shouldn't want to use it, given everything that's happened after 400 years of exploitation and institutional racism.
Ben, add on to that, Ben. Ben, the reason why you wouldn't use the N-word, Ben, is out of respect, correct?
I think it's a racially god-awful word that we should get rid of, because, and we shouldn't be teaching it to young kids, no matter what their race is, because it is so hurtful, and as long as we continue to use it, it is going to continue to hurt people's lives, and we should join together and say, this is a word we can all deal without having around, and it will bring more people together than divide them.
Okay,